And on behalf of Heather and my lovely wife, Lorraine, we want to thank you for coming and sharing an afternoon of music with us. This concert is very special for both Heather and Lorraine, as it has been over 2 years since they have played a recital. At their first rehearsal early last spring, after a long COVID hiatus, they decided to pick some of their favorite pieces and just play for the sheer joy of it. Those very special pieces are what you will hear today during the recital. As has always been our tradition, we will take a free will offering during intermission. And today, the proceeds will benefit the local Johnson County Salvation Army right here in Lawrenceburg. We want to thank you for your generosity and your support today. Opening our recital today will be Entr'acte by the French composer Jacques Ibert. Ibert studied composition at the Paris Conservatory, and much of his musical career was influenced by both World War I and World War II. His studies at the conservatory were interrupted by World War I, and he was exiled to Switzerland for part of World War II. He refused to ally himself to any particular musical style and was labeled as an eclectic composer, as his style ranged widely from lighthearted and frivolous to heavily romantic. He composed primarily instrumental repertoire and is probably most well known for his orchestral works, including Divertissement and Escalade. He also composed Lorraine's favorite flute concerto. Entr'acte is a good example of his lighter composition style and was composed in 1935. Thank you. harpist, pianist, and contemporary American composer Gary Schocker, was born in 1959 and lives in New York City and Easton, Pennsylvania. He is an internationally renowned flutist and is on faculty at New York University. His extensive compositional output includes instrumental solo works, chamber music, and children's musicals. He's one of the most published living composer of flute music with over 200 works in print. His highly melodic style has been compared to Poulenc and Bernstein with a sense of drama and humor. In Memoriam was one of his earliest works and was composed in 1982 as a tribute to his father, Paul. Its simplicity and elegance make it one of Gary Schocker's most beautiful compositions. Thank you. composer, Vincent Persichetti, was born in Philadelphia and spent most of his life there. He's one of the major figures in American music of the 20th century, is known as a pianist, composer, and teacher. He taught composition for many years at the Juilliard School of Music. He composed all types of music, including 9 symphonies, works for the concert band, chamber music for all kinds and combinations of instruments, solo instrumental repertoire, and vocal music. The bulk of his compositions were for the piano. He was an accomplished pianist and teacher and composed his piano music for all levels of playing ability, believing that it was very important to have quality recital repertoire available to all performers, regardless of their ability, age, and experience. His musical style is marked by 2 elements that he describes as graceful and gritty. The grace being the beautiful lyrical melodies, and the grit being the very sharp and intensely rhythmic writing. You will hear both of those elements in the serenade that we are going to perform for you today. The serenade number 10 is one of the 15 serenades that he composed for various instrument combination and was composed in 1957. The 4th movement is the beautifully lyric and simple melody, very vocal, an aria for the flute, and the last movement employs many special effects for the harp, such as percussive strumming and pedal slides, and is very rhythmic and challenging for both performers. A pedal slide on the harp occurs when a note is played and the pedal is moved to change the pitch. This is an example of a special effect originated and first notated by Bernard André, a composer that will be featured later in our concert. Just as the scope of Persichetti's music is very large, so you will hear much variety in each of the movements, from complex rhythms to simple but beautiful melodies. Haunting tone colors and very skillful and challenging writing for both instruments. Thank you.
Thank you. how to turn off the sound.
Sound.
Yeah, I appreciate that. That scared me to death. Oh, so boy. Oh, okay.
Sometimes it's too sad. This is what I.
Oh, you have it.
Yeah. This is it. I didn't have to remember to turn it back on.
That's my problem.
And I think the rings are strong.
Could you point out your dad to me?
Oh.
Is your dad here?
Yeah, he lives over there. Yeah. For me to come down.
And how about your grandpa?
So sound
off, and then down or up when you get it back on.
Then we got the heat.
Okay.
He was sitting in front of us. Ever since my accident, I used it. Can you do that? Well, no, the police report won't be ready till Monday.
Yeah.
Nothing new. I have some fab that really helped me with the anti-inflammatory. I have some of that Voltaren or whatever it is. I don't know. It's like a leaf and a tube.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't used it yet.
And I also have just an over the counter. It helps, especially if I use it with essential oils of peppermint, just lavender.
Uh-huh.
And then I massage it. It makes a difference.
It cools it. Climate cools it down.
It just makes it feel like it's taking some of the inflammation out.
Yeah. My brother got some CBD.
Uh-huh.
That you can grab on. He likes that.
That doesn't seem to work.
I just haven't looked for anything.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
he's some books about the Renaissance printing, and one of the comments was this
checking out your grandpa. I'm going to scoot this way.
I have to burn the midnight oil.
Oh.
Renaissance. See, some of those things do hang on, don't they?
Yeah.
How's school going?
Yeah.
Somebody had
being the oldest in the school, no, the youngest in the county, and that'll happen again in a few years.
Thank you.
And Amy got me going on t-shirts and silly things on her butt. And what I like is especially was how to drink responsibly. Don't spill. One other, my doctor said to me, does your family suffer from mental illness? No, we enjoy it.
You can keep them coming.
Yeah.
Probably the most well-known and foremost English composer of the 20th century, Ralph Vaughan Williams, lived from 1872 to 1958. His works include 9 symphonies, other orchestral pieces, songs, operas, and choral works. And he was strongly influenced by English folk songs, hymnody, and 17th century. His compositional style was marked by a decisive break in British music from its German-dominated style in the 19th century. The Fantasia on Green Sleeves was not originally created as a standalone piece. It was first used in the third act of Vaughan Williams's Shakespeare-inspired opera, Sir John in Love, composed in 1920. It uses the traditional Green Sleeves tune and an English folk tune called Lovely Joan. It was arranged for symphony and orchestra in 1934 and is now a very familiar piece in the symphonic repertoire. This beautiful arrangement for flute and harp was published in 1998 and was arranged by Jennifer Grady and Karen Almquist.
Thank you.
The next piece that they are going to play for you is by French harpist Bernard André. He was born in Belfort, France in 1941 and is a leading composer of music for the harp and an innovator of harp notation and style. He is credited with developing many special effects for the harp and was the originator of notation for them. He studied at the Paris Conservatory and was the harp soloist with the Philharmonic Orchestra of Radio France. The composer himself describes his music as being very influenced by the human voice. You will hear that in the piece they will play for you. Beautifully haunting and very singable melodies. Not overly complex or technical. You will hear some harp special effects, much resembling the use of the damper pedal on the piano. Often chords and notes on the harp will be sustained and will be part of the harmony and melody. He is quoted as saying that he does not like to linger on any given musical vein, and you will notice that aspect of his style in these pieces. Very short movements. And some end before you expect them to or want them to. This group of seven pieces is entitled Alga, which is translated algae or seaweed or water plants. The movements are untitled and do not have tempo or style indications, only metronome markings. So, let's take an imaginary trip to the coral reef somewhere in the South Pacific and enjoy alga.
Thank you. Thank you.
Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, child prodigy, musical genius, one of the most famous composers that ever lived, was born at Salzburg in Western Austria. The icon of classical music and style, he composed over 600 works in all genres. The Andante in C for flute and orchestra was written 1778, and was to be a possible replacement or alternative second movement for the flute concerto No. 1 in G major. Instead, it became a standalone piece and a staple in the flute repertoire. The flute is not one of Mozart's favorite instruments, but you would never know it when you hear this beautiful Andante. Lorraine first performed this piece in recital as a college freshman a few years back. It is one of her favorite pieces in the entire flute repertoire. Thank you. Before Heather and Lorraine play their final selection, we want to thank you for coming today and sharing the afternoon music with us, and also thank you for your generous support of the Salvation Army. Walking Tunes is a collection of several traditional and familiar tunes. Heather and Lorraine have chosen two of their favorites. Ash Grove is a Welsh folk song with origins dating back as far as the 1700s and has been set to many different lyrics. Perhaps the most familiar contemporary settings are the Thanksgiving hymn, Let All Things Now Living, composed in 1939 by Catherine Davis, and another familiar hymn setting entitled Sent Forth by God's Blessing. Simple Gifts is a familiar Shaker song and was written and composed in 1848 by Elder Joseph Brackett from Alfred Shaker Village, a historic district in Alfred, Maine. The Shakers were known for their simple way of living, which is also evident in their architectural style, music, and furniture craftsmanship. The Simple Gifts melody appears in Aaron Copland's music from the ballet, Appalachian Spring, and is also known as the hymn, I Danced in the Morning, and Lord of the Dance. Thank you again for your attendance today. Thank you.
Well, this one first. Push this knob, push that up. You have it down.
That was wonderful, Olivia. Okay.